Namaskar Gurukulians, how are you? I hope you all are fine and doing your study in a continuation way. For class 11th, I am going to teach a lecture on organization of data. Chapter 4, that is organization of data. In previous lecture, I told you so many terms on which basis the data are classified, like qualitative distribution on the basis of qualitative, on the basis of quantitative, on the basis of geographical, spatial. These are the basis to distribute the data, because you have to classify the data, you have to organize the data, you have to manage the data in such a way that that will give you the meaningful results, or you can analyze it or you can interpret it. Okay. Now your next topic is concept of variable. What is variable? What is variable? Variable value is changed time to time. Suppose temperature of today, 35 degrees Celsius. After 1 hour, it may be 37 degrees Celsius or 38 degrees Celsius or maybe 34 degrees Celsius. So variable means a characteristics or phenomena which is capable of being measured and changes its value over time is known as variable. For example, weight of the students will be called variable. There are two type of variable. One is discrete variable and second is continuous variable. Discrete variable and continuous variable. Discrete variable is that variable which will increase in jumps, not in friction. Like after 1, it will be 7, 9, 12, or maybe anything. But in continuous variable, it will be within the range, for example 5 feet 1 inch, or increase in a continuity way, 5 feet 2 inch, like this. I want to tell you to distinguish between variable and attribute, which can be measured in numbers, yani ki quantitative, that is known as variable, or which can be measured in qualitative, that is known as attribute. For example, I am saying one student scored 20 out of 20, or I am saying ki IQ level of that student is very good. So IQ level is known as qualitative, and the numbers, that is known as what? Numbers, that is variable. So qualitative phenomena is known as attribute, and quantitative, that is known as variable. Now, I am telling you about the next topic, that is raw data. What is raw data? The data which is in crude form, the data which is in crude form, that is known as raw data. Raw data means unmanagement. AC data pada ho. What you have to do? You have to make it as a way it can easily understand by anyone. Firstly, you have to classify it. Secondly, you have to manage it. That is known as organization. Okay, beta? So raw data is that data which is in the crude form. Doesn't give you any meaningful result. It is only a data which is kept before you. For example, this is. Five, 10, 12, 18, 18, 12, 9, 15. Then I am taking 11 and then 12. So you don't know about anything. Aapko iske bare mein kuch bhi nahi pata. So that is known as a raw data. What you have to do, you have to manage it. You have to organize it in such a way. It will give you comparable results. It will give you a data that you can compare with anyone. You can make it simple and brief. Okay, you have to manage it. You have to firstly classify it, then organize it. So, firstly, I am telling you the three terms are there: univariate, bivariate, and multivariate. Univariate means statistical data with one variable. For example, income of the household. Second, bivariate. It means statistical data related to two variable, income and expenditure. And multivariate is that in which statistical data related to more than two variables, that is income, consumption, expenditure, savings, investments, so many things. Okay, so I am telling you about the raw data. And that raw data you have to convert into a series. Or how will you convert into the series? Series is used systematically, may be defined as things, attribute of things arranged according to some logical order. It means this is a raw data. You have to use this. You have to make it, set it in a logical order and make it effective and attractive. But firstly, you have to know the meaning of series. There are types of statistical series, two type of statistical series, two types of statistical series. One is individual series. What do you mean by individual series? In which data is singly listed, yani ki jisme data ko jo hai wo single line mein dikha diya jata hai, that is known as individual series. I can write this data in ascending order, I can write this data in descending orders, but firstly I have to manage it. How I will manage? I will tell about one teacher has conducted a test in class of 20 marks. A test is conducted by the teacher in class of 20 marks. The score of the students are following. For example, I am managing like this. Roll number one. I am managing in roll number. Roll number one. Marks, next four roll number and next four marks. Roll number 1, 5 marks. Roll number 2, 10 marks. 3, 18 marks. 10 marks, then 12, sorry beta, 12 marks. Roll number 4, 18 marks. 5, 11 marks. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the roll numbers. Now you will write 18, 12, 9, 15 and 12. It means this data is not raw now. Ab ye data raw nahi hai. This is managed by us. Isse humne kya kar liya? Manage kar liya. In a single series, ek single series ke andar. I can arrange the data in ascending order also. I can arrange the data in descending order also. Ascending means from bottom to top. Kam se zyada par jana. For example, I am making individual series of this. So I am taking like this. Individual series. What I am taking? 5, then 9, then 10, then 11, then 12. Then 12, then 15, then 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Anything is left. 12, 2 times that has been done. 18, 2 times that is not taken by us. and one more is left. 5 done, 9 done, 10, 10 is not here. 11 done, 12 done, then 12 done, 15 done, 18, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2 more are left. These are, I think, 12 done, 11 done, 5, 9, 18, 15, 5 done, 10, 10 was there, 10 done, 9, 10, 12, 2 times done, 18, 2 times done, 12, 2 times done, 15 done, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1 is left, 5, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15, 18. Okay, you will find it. You will manage it accordingly and you will see 12 three times is there. That's why it is taking so much time. So this series is known as individual series. We are going in ascending orders. Hum kahan ja rahe hain? Ascending order mein ja rahe hain. If we are going in descending order, what do you have to do? You will go back 18, 18, 15, 12, 12, 12, 11, 10, 9 and 5. The series is known as individual series. Second is frequency series. Frequency series. That series is also divided in two types. One is that series is also divided in two types, that is frequency series. Frequency series, one is frequency array. Frequency array. And second is frequency distribution. I'm telling you the difference between frequency array and frequency distribution. Frequency array will measure the exact value. Frequency array will measure the exact value, but frequency distribution, it means that will within a range and frequency is distributed among the class. So I'm telling you the distinguish between. And we will make the both of series by using the data. One is the heading I will give, test of English taken by the teacher in class 11th. This is frequency. And this is x, x is variable and variable always change, that is marks. So firstly I will take 5, then 8, then 9, then 12, then 15 and then 18. 5 marks score by one student, 8 marks is not here, okay, 8 marks is not here, no need to show this, no problem, 8 is not here, it means no need to show it. 9 is taken by one student, 9 marks is taken by one student, 12 marks, 2 student, 15 marks, 10 is left, here you will take 9 and here you will take 10. 9, 1, 10, 1, 12, 3 students. After that 15, 1 student and 18, 2 student. It means total is 10. 1, 2, 3, 3, 6, 6, 1, 7 to 9. 1 is left. You have to check it. 1 is left. 5, 1 time, 9 one time, 10 one time, 11 is also left. 11 is also left. You have to write it. 11. Okay, this is left. This is known as individual series. Not individual series. This is known as, sorry beta, this is known as frequency array or discrete series, which will tell you the exact value. Okay, next is, I am telling you frequency distribution. I will make a class. I will make a range. This is class intervals and frequency. I am taking class 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15 and 15 to 20. What you have to do now? You have to see 0 to 5. Who scored 0 to 5? The number of student who scored 0 to 5. So you will see if 5 is here, 5 is here. It means 5 will count it in next term, not in this term. Okay, so 0 to 5, that is 0, no one is here. Who score 5 to 10? Only one is here, that is 9 or second 5. So these two students score between 5 to 10. 10 is also here, but 10 will not count here. I told you it will be counted here. 10 and 12, 10, 1, then 1, 2, 2 and 3, 5. 5 students are there who score what? 10, 11 and 12. Next is 15 and 18. That what you will count? Counted these. That is 2 and 1. That is 3. So it means there are how many students? 10. This is known as frequency distributed. Distribution series in which frequency is distributed within a range. There is a loss of information because frequency is in between. We doesn't know the exact. Hum exact jo hai wo isme nahi nikal sakte. I think you can understand all of these series by this data. I am telling you some terms. Discrete frequency series, I told you this is the discrete frequency series and this is frequency distribution. Frequency, what is frequency? The number of students which will come, number of times of an item in repeat is known as frequency. This is frequency and this is known as class frequency because this is coming within a range. Telebars. Telebars, you already know this is known as 4-cross method. Isse 4-cross method bhi kaha jata hai. The method to write telebars, 1, that is the same 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth value is change. What is the change? Fifth value is change. So what you will do, fifth value, you will take like this. This is known as 4-cross method. Next is discrete series, I told you. Frequency distribution, I told you. Now I am telling you some terms like class. Class is a range. Here the class is 0 to 5, 5 to 10. Second is class limits. Two limits are there. One is lower limit and second is upper limit. If I am discussing about 5 and 10, so here 5 is lower limit and 10 is upper limit. Here 10 is lower limit and 15 is upper limit. Now I am telling you about the magnitude. Magnitude is a difference between upper limit minus lower limit. It means that is 5 over there. And mid value. Mid value, how will you find the mid value? Mid value you will find like this. Lower limit plus upper limit upon 2. It means here mid value will be 2.5. If I am finding over there 15 to 20, what will be the mid value? 15 plus 20 by 2, it means 35 by 2, that is 17.5. Thank you students, I hope you can understand the different type of series from this lecture. The next topic I will continue in next lecture. Till then you will do this syllabus from the PDFs which I already sent you by the school side. You have to prepare for your test or anything. I will take your test also. Thank you beta. Thank you so much. If you are facing any problem, can take on WhatsApp. Thank you beta. Thank you so much.